In the past, every time we talked about great two-player games, someone would recommend we try out Targi from KOSMOS. Well, we did, and everyone is right.
Firstly, thanks to KOSMOS Games for sending us a review copy of Targi. It's not often publishers are willing to send us games that are more than 10 years old, though that is a good indication of their confidence in this game that has stood the test of time.
Andrea Steger is the designer of Targi, which features artwork from Tara Akitsu and Franz Vohwinkel. Compared to many of the two-player-only games we dig, Targi is a bit longer and has a bit more meat on it, with games taking over an hour.
Well, since being released in 2012, Targi has been nominated and won a number of awards, the two most notable being a 2012 Spiels des Jahres Kennerspiel nomination and a 2013 Golden Geek nomination for Best Two-Player Board Game.
In Targi, you are the leader of a desert Tuareg tribe. You will collect and trade resources, earn gold, and use those to recruit other tribes to your cause. Mechanically, this is done by placing meeples on the edge of a 5x5 grid, activating those cards and claiming the cards where the rows and columns you claim intersect.
Targi comes in the standard size KOSMOS two-player game box, and it has a generic plastic box insert that works okay for sorting everything. We highly recommend using baggies if you aren't going to keep this game flat. The card quality is good. The workers are wood in clearly differentiated colors, and the resources are well-cut cardboard. Everything's just, it's nice quality. The rule book is clear and easy to reference.
We don't have any complaints component-wise, but be aware that the entire thing can take up quite a bit of room. Sadly, that makes it so Targi doesn't work on smaller coffee shop or pub tables.
You start Targi by laying out the outside ring of the 5x5 grid of cards. They always go in the same order. You place the robber on the number one card. You then fill the center of the grid with goods and tribe cards, swapping between the two, so you end up with 5 goods and 4 tribes in play.
Each player collects the wooden pieces in their color, 2 of each resources, dates, salt, and pepper, 1 gold, and 4 points worth of victory tokens. The player that last ate a date gets to go first.
Each round of Targi has players placing their Targi figures onto one of the non-corner cards' edge cards. This can't be the card with the robber or where anyone else has placed. Once a figure is placed, that player has claimed that row or column, and no Targi may be placed on the card on the opposite side. The start player places, then their opponent, and back and forth until 3 Targi for both players are placed.
Next, you check the rows and columns you have your Targi on and place a round tribe marker onto the 2 cards that intersect these rows and columns you control. Then the starting player activates each of their wooden pieces in any order they wish. This is followed by their opponent doing the same.
Each of the outsized cards has an action associated with it, which is explained on the cards. Some of these just let you take resources, others are more complicated. For example, the trader spot lets you trade 3 goods for 1 gold or 2 goods for one of another good. The silversmith lets you change sets of goods into points. The caravan lets you flip over the top goods card and get whatever you draw, etc.
The middle cards are either goods cards, where you take the goods shown, discard the card and replace it with one of the face-down tribe cards, or tribe cards you can purchase with your goods on hand. In addition, you can choose to hold on to one tribe card, which you can play later by taking the leader action. When you purchase or choose to hold a tribe card, it is immediately replaced by a face-down goods card.
Tribe cards come in 5 different types, and each is worth a set number of victory points at the end of the game, and most offer some kind of game-breaking ability or other end-game scoring opportunities. Tribe cards, when purchased, go into a 3x4 tableau in front of you, which you have to fill left to right, though you can choose which row to start on each time. At the end of the game, you'll get bonus points for full rows of 4, with 4 different tribes or 4 rows of the same tribe, scoring extra points.
At the end of the round, face-down cards on the table are flipped. The start player moves to the next player, and the robber moves 1 spot around the outside edge. At each corner of the board, there's a raid card, and when the robber hits that spot, the players must pay the shown resources or they lose points. And after that, the robber moves to the next card.
The game ends at the end of the round when any player has filled their tableau with 12 tribe cards, or the robber makes it all the way around the board and back to the number 1 noble card. At that point, players add up their scores. The player with the most points wins, with the most gold, and then the most goods being the tiebreaker.
Now, I've got to thank the lobby, our chat room here on Twitch, for this one. They are the ones that convinced me to ask KOSMOS for a review copy of Targi when they approached us about some of their newer games, and it's been a huge hit with Deanna and I. Now, as you all know, we love solid, engaging two-player games that we can play together on date night, with a bonus for games that work at coffee shops, breweries, and pubs. And Targi is just about perfect for that. The only issue is that it takes up quite a bit of space and can be a bit hard to fit on two-seater tables.
I am so, so glad that we ended up checking out this game. A huge thanks to the folks that recommended it. Targi is the perfect two-player game to me, and it is almost the perfect coffee shop size. Just so flipping close.
Yeah, it's unfortunate when two-player games take up that little bit of extra space, because they're just a two-player game should fit on something about the size of a coffee table like that.
We were able to fit it on the table at one of our favorite breweries, but like the drinks had to go strategically, and it was just fit.
Now, what I like most about Targi is the amount of decision points and depth in this game. It gives me that heavy Euro feel while playing in about an hour and working great with only two players.
I'm always super excited to find a two-player game that feels meaty and strategic, and that we can play in a relatively short time frame.
The grid-based worker placement system here really is brilliant, and it leads to some really tactical play. In this game, you have to watch what your opponent is doing and take that into consideration when placing your Targi. Denying your opponent's placement can be as important as getting what you want, and it's super rewarding when you can do both.
So there is a bit of trying to screw over your opponent, but I still swear this is a good date night game. You need to actually pay attention to what your opponent's up to. And yeah, picking the spot that you know they want is definitely part of the strategy.
A good date night game for gamers, I think, is really the kind of key here.
Yeah, because just the basic action spots, like your basic spots, the cards around the outside, give you plenty of options and depth. But then there's the whole tribe card thing, right? Do you try to collect sets for bonus points? You're gonna buy one of each, so you have four different types. Sorry, there's five types. But buy four different cards so you can get that bonus. Or do you buy all the same number or same type of cards so you can get that bonus? Or do you ignore that and just buy based on abilities? Do you try to build an engine by getting tribe cards that play off each other? Now, as an example of this, there is a tribe card that makes it cheaper to play later tribe cards of the noble. Then every tribe has a card that makes buying cards of the same tribe cheaper. Well, I've seen Deanna use a strategy where she got the combo going where she never plays tribe cards when she buys them. She plays them all from the noble and then pays two less for everyone because of having those other combos. Of course, now when I see her doing this, I do everything I can to pick up those matching cards. So I get them instead of her and I keep her away from the noble spot. And it's gameplay like that that keeps us coming back for more.
Yeah, this is not one of those one true way to win kinds of games, and I love that.
And if you have gotten bored of it, there is an expansion that adds a whole other level to the game and ups the difficulty even more.
Yeah, I need to check that out at some point. That'll be our next request to KOSMOS. Here, did you check out our Targi review? We loved it. Send us the other one. Now, one thing I will say is the box insert could be better. You can tell it's just like a generic box insert for game with cards and tokens. And it's always a bit of a mess when we open it up. Baggies definitely help. And I wouldn't be surprised if some people just toss that insert and just use bags.
Yeah, I don't have much bad to say about Targi. There's the usual complaint of I wish the text was bigger, but the iconography is super clear and easy to read. So I don't even mind having to pick up the tribe cards. But you do. And I think even going back before I had some vision problems, I would have had to pick these up and, you know, pass them around the table to be able to read them. I don't know what you could do to make the game better. And I do say that for the outside ones, I mean, we memorize them, right? And they expect you to, because they have the reverse side with just the icons on them instead of all the words. So it's a minor complaint.
We'll note that Folded Space does have a box insert for that keeps things together and allows you to, you know, take them out and put them onto the table in separate component pieces.
Yeah, you definitely need baggies for this one, or it's just a sad mess. I'd like to mention that there's a BGG upgrade token set for this, and it looks awesome. I almost bought it from over our anniversary, but I hate shipping to Canada.
There is actually an official one as well. For the 10th anniversary of the game, they put out an expansion that is wooden components for upgrades for things, but also works with the expansion content.
See, that'd be a hard choice between, you know, those plastic geek up bits that we love for Quaxicodenberg and other games, or wood. That's a hard choice. Overall, Targi has been the perfect fit for Deanna and I. I think that's going to be true for anyone who's into heavier Euro games. This is a small box two-player game that gives you the feel of a bigger box and a much longer game. Yeah, it takes up a bit more space than we'd like, but honestly, that cost pays off with the depth of gameplay. If you're a Euro fan and find yourself with just two of you looking for something to play on a game night, pick up Targi.
Get it. Just go get it. That's it.
Now, I got to say, if what you look for in a two-player game, or especially a date-night game, is something light that doesn't require much attention, where you can kind of chat and enjoy a glass of wine while you're playing, Targi may not be the right choice. Now, while we do enjoy a pint or two of craft beer on our date nights, what we'll do is start off the night with Targi and then swap to lighter games as the night goes on.
Yeah, Targi requires attention. Honestly, this game is just not going to be fun unless you're paying close attention to it. So it is not a game to play when you are getting sloppy drunk.
Yeah, this is a midweight game. The base cassette comes in at about a 2.3 on Board Game Geek weight, up to over 2.5 with the expansion.
And our chat room has called us something I think is also important. If you don't like tag, take that, especially on your date night games. You may want to avoid Targi. There is an awful lot of messing over your opponent in this game. Again, the valid moves are often to deny your opponent from getting something. And quite a few of the cards are kind of nasty, especially the one that takes away opponent's Targi for one round can be particularly devastating.
Can I say, though, that the difference here is it doesn't feel like I'm doing take that just for the, I don't know, shock value or the amusement of screwing someone else over, but more because it's the most tactical choice for you. And that's the difference there that makes it okay for a date night game for me.
Yeah, I agree. It's not nasty type of take that. It's not stab you in the back. It's just, it's competitive. There is definite competition. If you're not into competition in your two-player games, there are cooperative options out there. I don't know. To me, Targi's good enough. I kind of feel like everyone should try it. Like, it's been around for a long time. There's probably someone near you who has a copy. If you do want to try the game out, if you're local, just ask. We'll bring it out to an event. I think this is just for hobby gamers who are into, like, probably the majority of our audience. I think you're going to dig Targi.
Yeah, I second that. I hate that it took us so long to getting around to trying this game. I will admit there's something about the box that just didn't draw me in. And I've seen it at stores and kind of dismissed it. So definitely, if you have also been overlooking this one, go try it out. It's pretty darn good.
Well, with that, it's time to pack up the caravan and move on to another game. I hope this gave you a good idea of what Targi is about and if it's a good fit for you and your group. We talk a lot about two-player games, but not often ones that are quite this old. What's a classic two-player game that you still play? Let us know.
Before we move on, just a reminder that we now have merch. That's right, you can declare your Bellhop love through t-shirts and golf shirts and enjoy watching the live show with a cup of joe in your own Tabletop Bellhop mug. Just head over to tabletopbellhop.com/merch.
And you can save on shipping when you buy any two items and enter the code TABLETOP. After all, if you're going to sit down to play Targi, you better both have a Bellhop mug.